Okay guys, welcome to the first video tutorial on the graphic design series. The last video was the ground zero video, which had some sick kinetic typography. If you guys haven't seen that, check that out. It basically is a promotional video to the upcoming videos such as this one. So today I'm going to be teaching you guys Photoshop. This is the basics of Photoshop, so you can kind of break into the tool and make it your own. So let's begin. So in this video we're going to be covering the window. And what is window is basically all these panels you see are a window or a panel, whatever you call it. And this is very, you know, this is essential. Depending on what you do in Photoshop, you need a certain setup which will make your work a lot easier. I use the essentials. The preset that Photoshop comes with is the essentials preset, which works for me. But you know, sometimes you need to open a new window. So let's get into it. The window option is up here. We also have the minimize and whatnot over here. The second to last one will say window. I'm not sure about a Mac. You know, Mac has this weird setup. PC master race, the window master race. So yeah, the window will be up here along with file, edit, image, layer, type, select, filter, 3D view, window, and help. So today we're going to be going over window. So just click window and boom, this drop down will come up. You'll be wondering what's going on. If you're a newcomer, if you don't know how to use Photoshop too well, you're going to be like, what's going on? And if you know what's going on, you're like, oh yeah, I remember this. Let me just do a quick preview so I know if I, you know, if I'm doing this right. Which you can't really go wrong with this. So just do it. Make your dreams come true. All right. So once you click window, boom, a drop down. You're either wondering what's going on or you're like, yeah, I got this, but let me quickly refresh my memory. So first on the list, we got arrange. You can arrange stuff. I know I never really use this, but you can mess with this, see what you like. Float all window. You can see it makes the main window float, which not a fan of it. Also, if you want to... this is actually pretty good for working, like multitasking. Like if you want to have another window opened up. If you want to put this back in, you just kind of go to the edge and it'll turn blue. And you just drop that bad boy and boom, you got it. So we're going to go back into window. Workspace. This is your workspace. You can either save your workspace, you can make a new workspace, you can go to the already ones you have set up. I use Essentials, which is a default for Photoshop. I also have a new CS6 one. This is the one I put together. 3D, motion, painting, photography, typography. Like I said, this, like, what you use Photoshop for will dictate which windows you're going to use. We also have Reset Essentials, which will, if you mess with the Essentials, it bring it back to its original state. New Workspace, you click it. You can make a new workspace. Let me click it real quick. You can name it. You can save the keyboard shortcuts, the menus, and whatnot. Click save if you want to save it. Cancel if you don't. We also have the delete workspace. You click it. Now you have a drop down of what you want to delete. Let's delete the new in Windows CS6. I don't know what it is. It's probably something important that I'm going to regret later, but whatever. Delete it. Yes. Go back to window, workspace. Let's make a new workspace. New workspace, we're gonna name this tutorial. Bam, just click enter or okay. And if you go to window, workspace, boom, tutorial. That's pretty dope. Okay, so now we have extensions. You don't need to worry about this for right now. So we're gonna skip over that. 3D, I'm actually gonna go over the what you would use most of the time. I'm not going to go into every single one of these because that would be a pretty long video. But if you have a question about it, or if you know, if you want to learn about it, I'll make a separate video, or maybe I'll accompany it with another video or with another set of tutorials, I guess. So right now I have adjustments, layers, and swatches opened up. What adjustment layers is basically this right here. You can adjust your layers or your work in. This is really weird. I don't know why I'm just stopping. Overall, you can edit and adjust your layers. I don't know. I am having so much trouble. I don't know. But yeah, I'll go over the adjustment layers in another video. Brush, if you want to work with the brush, let's open that up. Got the brushes, which you really won't be messing with these a lot unless you're using a certain brush pack or you're doing digital art, which I do. I love digital art. I love digital art. Brush presets, basically the preset brushes you already have or you've added. Channels. You really won't be using this, but if you want to get rid of a certain, like, ooh, we don't like blues around here, or we don't like greens, or we don't like reds, you can just drop that, which this really won't come in handy a lot of the time. I don't use it a lot. Well, it doesn't mean you guys won't use it a lot, but yeah. Back to window. So let's go to layers, because layers is pretty important. Layers, you click it, it'll show up. This is the layers. We'll be going over this in another tutorial if you don't know how to use this. Basically, you can open up a new layer, make a folder, add adjustment layer. This is your place. You'll always need to have this opened up. Always. Always. We have swatches, which swatches are up here. And this will allow you to quickly select a color or put your color that you're working with in there so it doesn't become a problem later. So, go here. Okay. So, back to window. Navigator. Digital art mostly. You can navigate around your tool, your workspace. Histogram. Basically, it's like the RGB. I haven't used this a lot. I guess photography uses a lot. Yeah, uses histogram. Tool presets. Won't be using this a lot either. And yeah, these are basically what you need opened. For more detailed or specific work, you know, you'd have different things opened up. The workspaces, a lot of these are already set. Typography, so if you work with text a lot, if you work with pictures a lot, photography, or you want to touch up a picture, photography. Painting, if you do painting. Motion, if you do things, oops. If you do, like, GIFs or whatnot. And 3D, if you work with 3D things. I don't use Photoshop for 3D because I don't think it's the greatest tool. There's so many better tools to use. And yeah, and essentials, obviously. This is what I use. I love essentials. So yeah, I hope this tutorial was pretty good. I hope you guys learned something. If you have not, I'm sorry. Later in tutorials, you're going to learn a lot more. I just want to punch out the basics because this will be a little bit more of the boring and redundant stuff. I just want to do an overview on the basics. If a lot of people are having trouble with a certain tool or whatnot, just comment down below. I'll make a video about it. Other than that, there's a lot of tutorials on the very nitty-gritty stuff if you really want to know. So yeah, I'll have a lot of the usages of the tool or the windows in the description. So if you guys want to know, check that out. I hope you guys enjoyed the first video. Like, comment, and subscribe if you guys want to see more. Okay, peace out.